So last time we were in good morning. Last time we were in adding parameters. So I discussed the parameter file. So I think you can remember what I did. So we will quickly do it again. So for an example, I think you can hear me. No problem. So we will quickly recap the things we did last week. Now, say I if I tag this say if I tag this wall. Now we were in tagging the entity. So if I just come and tag this wall, which is it's nothing is shown here because the information is not given. So if you just click on this tag here. I will close some of these things. My machine is getting slow. Now, when I click here, the tag information is missing. So we went here. And I talk about this instant method. So when you just edit this, you can see this is type mark. So if I want to get the wall information, we can just take last time we took the family name, other things. So we will just look at some parameters, type name, or then family name. So these kind of information we can show. So when you press OK, load the project, this information is shown. So now if somebody wants to show the mason name or the carpenter's name, last time I showed it how we can do it. So for an example, if I want to create a own parameter, last time we did it. So I quickly recap the things we did. If I want to create my own parameter, I have this button called add parameters. So if you have a file, shared file already drawn, created, you can select that file. So last time we created a parameter called carpet. So if you are not in the last class, you will not understand what I'm doing. So carpenter parameter was created last week, so I don't need to create a parameter file. So if you I think I saved it in my desktop here. Parameter file. This is the parameter file I created last week. So I created this carpenter parameter and it's saved in the desktop. So this is the carpenter parameter, the text type. So all the information is here. So if you want, you can share this parameter file with another computer. So if suppose if you don't have the parameter file, say if I delete this. If I delete the parameter file, now when I try to create a parameter, I have to do it from the beginning. So I have to start from the beginning and do it. So there is no parameter file anymore. So we have to create the parameter file, say yes. Then we have to create the parameter file. Say I just create my parameter file in the desktop again. So if you have created this already, you don't need to do this thing. Then I can create a group say something like Mason, then I'm going to create a variable parameter. So this parameter is under common group and it's a name. So Mason one under text. Okay. So it's coming here. So this is how we create the parameter. So parameter file is now there in the desktop. New parameter is called Mason. So I hope you understood this. Now this parameter should be connected to the project. So the parameter is not still connected to the drawing here. So nothing is shown. So this wall should have a connection between this parameter and the wall. So we have to do what? We have to go to this project. Shared parameter file. And the parameter is shown here now. So if you want, you can do editing, whatever the things you like. Now we will go here. And now add this parameter to this. New parameter to this. So I'm going to add this parameter under, say, others. And it can be a type parameter. Type is coming here. Instant parameter is here. So if you want, you can have a type parameter. And you can put it to words. Simple thing. You have to create the parameter first and connect to this wall or whatever the thing you like. So creating the parameter and connecting is two different steps. So I add it under type here. And it's on the others. And it's in the wall. So it's in the architecture discipline. So okay, parameter one. Okay. Now still the information is not shown, but when you click here and go to edit type, under others you find the Mason. So I link the parameter to this wall. So if I just type animal and press OK, the animal should appear. So that's how we do it. Now this is basic call integer 6108. So if you tag the other basic call also, same animal comes. But if you tag it here, there is nothing because I didn't give information to this call. This is a different call. So if you just look at this call, parameter is there, but it can be made by someone. So this wall is made by someone. This is made. Internal walls are made by you. So this is the useful application of this parameter creations. So different walls can be made by different masons, and you can get a QS table based on this. And once you get the QS table, you can get different salaries calculated. So I will move on to the QS also from these walls. I hope you understood this. Any questions, please tell me. For QS parts, I will take a good file that is a big model. Otherwise, you can't show it. I will try to get a big file for the QS theory. Better you have a model like this to discuss the QS theory. So I will just do the parameter thing again. This is a new file, so we can come and tag by category. So this wall I can tag, nothing is shown. You just click on this label, edit families. We don't want this label. we remove this. And now we created a parameter, say mason. We can connect that mason here. Mason is connected. Information is not shown. So the if you just look at this wall, this is a new project. So that I'm using the parameter file now. For each and every project, you don't need to create parameter files. So I'm using the previous parameter file, but when you go here and check it, mason is not available. So I have to do this process again for the new project. So I will come here. For every new project, you have to create these things. Shared parameters. Sorry, project parameters. Edit. Mason. It can be type or instant. It's group under others. And it's a all parameter. So if you want, you can put it into Windows also. If you want, you can put it into Windows. So anything here we can apply. Now Mason is connected to the wall. If you just come here and check it, Mason is available. So this is how we do it. It's not a difficult thing. So first you have to create the parameter, and parameter should be connected to the wall or the door or window, whatever the model you like. And if you try to annotate this one, nothing is shown because this wall doesn't carry that information. So we have to give that information in the model. This can be made by someone. So the someone appears here. Then once you tag the others, this is also made by someone. Made by someone. So same words. This is made by me. So this is how we do it. And if you just look at the doors here, I connected the parameter to door also. You can see the mason parameter coming under doors also. So we will give say David for the mason one. Under doors, so nothing is shown. You have to tag the door. You may want to check the active view. It's not in the flow. Something wrong. Door is not in the correct view. So you can see I have switched off this one. That's why I got a warning. So if you switch off these things, your tags will not be shown. So I now it can be seen. So always read the warnings coming in the software and do remedial actions. Now we can show that mason here also. We can change the label. And now the mason is not automatically coming here. So I have to add it from the list. Shows. Actually, I have done it twice. So this is a different door type. David is not handling this. This door type may be handled by someone else. Okay. So this is how we handle the parameters. Any questions, please tell me. This is somewhat advanced area, so you have to create the parameter and connect the parameter to this port. So creating parameters can be done easily. So you just go through this process, click on the label, create the parameter, After you have prepared the parameter, you load it into the label. Then it's not enough. So you have to connect that parameter to the model. So the model, you can add that parameter, like a shared parameter, to a model here. That's all. So you can have typo instant and group under any subject. Any questions? Now, if you don't have questions, we will just move on to the next topic. Please save this file with the parameters like this. I will show you how to get this in the QoS table also. So please save this, save a model in your computer for the next lesson. Now we will look at another area, that is when you dimension. You can see these kind of symbols in the tutorial. So this is a center line symbol. So how can I get that symbol in the dimensions? That's not a difficult thing. So in these dimensions, you will not find the center line symbol. Now if you just come here and just use the alignment methods and annotate, you will not see that symbol appear. In the tutorial, it shows So how can I get that? So it's very easy. You can just come here and change the style. So the style is normal one is this one. But if you select a style with this center line, this is W center means with the center line, you see that symbol appears. Now when you put it again, you can see the center line symbol automatically comes. So it's very easy. So you don't need to use manual methods and draw that symbol. You just come here and select the center line style. Just click on the line style, the center line symbol automatically appears. And if you want to edit the sizes, that can be done. So the font sizes and all these things can be changed. So this is like AutoCAD. So I may not go through in detail. So this can be used to change the font size, offset. So sometimes in the exam, we will ask you to change this little bit. This font sizes, shapes, and other things. So if you want, you can have the alternative units also shown. So both units are appear. So you can see the both millimeters and inches both appear. So this is similar to AutoCAD. So I hope everyone can tackle this. But I will show you some new areas like how to apply a baseline dimension. Now so how can I apply baseline dimensions? So I hope everyone knows what is baseline dimensions. Baseline dimensions are dimensions which are referred to one base, and everything is measured from this base. So this is the normal practice. So how can I have baseline dimensions in Revit? So this is like a baseline dimension. So this is base. This line was base to 5 and 10 volt. But if you want to do it quickly, how can I do? So if I want to measure everything from this one and to here, to here, to here, likewise, we have to, now the normal method is continuous. So this is a continuous dimension. So this is the continuous dimension. So this is not a good way of putting dimensions in a model. Why I am saying this is not a good way of putting dimensions is, when you construct the building, say if you make a mistake in this measurement is accumulated to here, that error is coming here, and this wall will be somewhere. So if you make a mistake in measuring this 10, that error is coming here, coming here, coming here. So to avoid that one, we can have baseline dimensions. But when you put it like this way, normally it's coming as continuous dimensions. How can I have baseline dimensions? So to do that, we have to come here and change this to a baseline method. So when you change this to a baseline mode, now you can just click like this. You can see how the dimensions are given. And click somewhere here. You can see everything is based on this line now. And I'm measuring from here. So this is the good way of putting the dimension. So if you make a mistake here, that mistake is not affected to this. So I will switch off the dual dimensions. So you can see everything is independent with each other. So everyone is measured with respect to this. So we have to do a simple thing. Just come here and change the mode. And if you come here and change the mode to ordinate is also similar to baseline. You can see how it works. This is 0, 10, from here to 17, from here to 25, from here to 40. So if you just put it by baseline, this is the baseline, 10, 17, 20, 40. This is the ordinate. So you can see all almost similar. coordinate, we assume this is origin 0, and it's like a coordinate system, 10, 20, 25, 40. But baseline, we draw every line, every arrow from the base. So I hope you understood. So this is the best way of putting it, either this way or this way. Don't put continuous dimensions, which is not really good. So this is not a good method of putting the dimensions. This is easy to read, but not good in construction. So you can go through these things and learn, and if you have any questions, please tell me. So I will go through these three now. So I hope you are okay with these fundamentals. And talking about arc length, how can I put an arc length? I will draw it again. Whatever the things you are drawing is not visible here. I have a problem with my project. I will take a new file and do it. Something wrong with this file. I can't figure it out. So I'm going to show you how to apply the arc length, arc dimensions. So when it comes to an arc, normally we have a radius in the arc. We have an angle in the arc. We can have the arc length even. So you can dimension two of the parameters. So normally we don't need to have all the three, just come here and just give the radius, or else I can give arc length. So how can I give arc length in Revit? Just click on these two ends, you can get the arc length. So an arc angle can be given, just click on these two ends, this is the arc. So these are the three ways of dimension in arc: arc angle, arc length, or arc radius. So I will quickly redo this. So we can easily put the arc radius from the center of the from the wall faces. Then we can put the arc angle. Click on these two endpoints, arc angle, and we can put the arc length. Click on these two endpoints. Sorry, give the click on this radius here and two endpoints like this. This is how we dimension and now. So we don't need to have all the three, only two is enough. So we don't have need to put all three dimensions, only two is enough to get the arm. Now we look at these methods. What are these methods? This is a elevation view, least elevation view. Suppose you want to put the slope of the rock, slope of the roof. So you say click here and just select this edge. It will show you the slope value and click. So it will show the direction of the slope and the slope value in the roof. If you just click on this kind of a window, it says no slope. Even this line, no slope. And here it will show the slope value. So this is a really useful tool. You don't need to do calculations. Software will automatically calculate that value depending on the walls, roof or the other slopes, and it will automatically put it. And here we have a spot elevation tool. Suppose if you want to measure the height from the floor, ground floor, just click on this, it shows the elevation. So up to here it's 30 feet. Up to this top of the window, it's 37. So here I can track like this. So it's really easy compared to the AutoCAD or other things. So you don't need to come and put a line dimension. Say somebody can do this way also, but that is not a good way of doing it. It's full of dimensions, arrows, and everything. So it is not really useful. This is good. So we can elevate, we get the measurements in anywhere. So you can see everything is snapped. So really handy. Now, there's another way of putting this. If you know about survey coordinates, you can use this spot coordinate methods also. It depends on the survey units. So with respect to north and east, what is the coordinate point? So this is not really user friendly, but there is a way of doing that too also. So sometimes in the exam we will ask you to put the slope, put the spot elevations and calculate that and show us. So those kind of things may be asked. So better you know all these very well. So I have to cover this area. I will do it a little bit later. We have covered these two. And we have covered this color field legend. Room tag also we have covered. So some of the things we have to still do. If we have time, I will go through this. Any questions up to this now? Today we discuss these things, and today we discuss the parameter area a little bit, and we have to start the QS. So before we start in the QS and the drawing sheets, any questions? I'm moving on to chapter 12. So we will start the schedules. I will upload these videos. Still I didn't upload them. I have to upload to YouTube. So I will upload it and show, give the links to you. Now we will start the scheduling part. So I'm going to get some QoS tables for this model. Better you have some good model to get the tables. Otherwise it's not going to be, I cannot show it today. So better you have some levels in the project, then you can get a good table. So I will now start the QoS area. So we are going to start this schedule tab. So we are going to discuss these two methods. So I will first get the quantities, then I will move on to the material. So we will start with the quantities. And it's simple, you select the discipline you want. Then say for an example, if I want to get the dough quantities, select the model you like from the list here. Then I'm getting the answers from the model I have, building model. So I'm getting the quantities from the building model I have, not from the areas. So this is, if you have the project divided into phases, you just select the correct phase. So if you have to get the quantities of the demolish phase, just click the demolish phase and do. Otherwise, get the new construction. So I have done everything in the new construction. So just get it from the new construction door. Okay. Then I will get the required parameters to my table. Say I want the cost of the door, family and type. Then I want the head height. Likewise, I will need the width of the door. Likewise, we can select the parameters. So this can be move up and down like this. So sometimes your machine may be a little bit different, your interface, like you are using 2018 versions, this interface may be a little bit different, but theory is same. So I'm trying to develop a table from family and type. So if I want to have a level in the table, just get the levels also. So to show the left column, first column as levels, family and type, head height, width and cost. And if you want to get it from the link files also, just click on this. I don't have link files. And other fields we'll discuss later. We'll discuss these things later. Press OK. Now it will generate a table for me. So level 1, level 4, level 2, likewise, level 3, it will show me. Then the family and type, it will show me. And the head height, width and the cost. So cost may be 0 in your computer. Here I have given 10. That is, now if you just look at my model here, I may have given a value for the door. So door value is given as 10. So that's why you find 10 there. So if you just give a total value of 5 here, your table will be quickly modified. And it's coming here. Now it says 5. So quickly we can get that cost into the table. So when you edit the model real time, it will update the table. And now if someone comes and delete this door, what happens? This table quickly updates. So if you just delete these things, you can see level 1 information is now almost see now no level 1 information. So real time it's going to update. So there's a connection between Revit and the Revit schedule. So this model is connected to this. And if you come and change this to a different model, can be done. So if I just change this to a different model, the 3D model here will be automatically updated. So this was updated. So you can see previously it was like this and I change it to this. So from the table itself, I can do a modification. So your original model you change. Now level 4 I have changed. If you change it in level 1, you can quickly see this. Level 1 changes. And if someone wants to delete this, you can delete from here, or else you can delete from this even. Right click, delete from. So when you delete this, right click and get the delete button. This will remove from here as well as from here. Please note that you are not just removing rows from the schedule, but also deleting the associated elements and geometry from the project. So this is the connection between Revit and the Revit model and the Revit schedule. So you can quickly see this is deleted. That's why people move on to this software. No one can actually cheat because you cannot show something here and something here. So everything is linked with each other. So it can be from here to here or here to here. So I hope you understood how did I get this schedule. So I went here, started this. Say for an example, if I want to get Windows. Select the windows and get the required parameters. This will generate a window schedule for me. So there are a lot of windows in the project. You can see it's generated. So here the cost is not shown, zero, because I haven't given any cost for the thing. Any questions up to this one? Now you can see this is another schedule I have developed, but you can see it's not with the new one is all that together as a bunch, but here those are grouped according to levels. This table has been modified and there we have calculated the total value of each level and the grand total also calculated. So how can I get something like this out? So we will move on to that area. So if someone wants to get the total cost here, how can I get it? So if someone wants to get the total cost and break this into levels, so we can do what? We can select the schedule we want and go to edit. So if you want to edit the fields, you can quickly edit the fields. And here there's a second button here, filters. So if you want to filter out some levels, like level, only this one will be shown. Level equals to level one will be shown. So only level one information is going to be visible now. Or else we can have level does not equal, is above level one. Now all the other levels information will be shown. So this is like a condition. I can have several conditions. Net height equals to 6.8. So we can have a lot of conditions here and get the necessary outputs. Now here there is nothing like that. You can see the table is generated. So you can have AND operations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 AND operations, and with this one 8. So I can add conditions as I wish from these columns and show whatever the things I want to show. So if you press none here, the full table is going to be visible. Then there's another one called sorting and grouping. Now, if you just untick this, now every item is shown one by one. If you remove this tick, you will not see anything at all. Item-wise information is not shown. We will look at this one, sort by levels. Now if you just select this one, ascending level, this is the information we get. So level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. But if you want to have a break between the levels, just have this blank line. So when you have a blank line, you can see the levels are now going to be separated. Also, if you want to add the header, header here, footer here, can be added. Now it will show you the level 1 as the header. So how many doors here? How many doors? How many doors? How many doors? And if you just remove the blank line, there is no gap here. And if you want, you can have another condition. I can sort it according to levels, as well as I want to sort it according to family and house. So I will have some headers, blank lines. Now you can see level 1, single decorative is together. Single plus is separately. Single race is separately. Level 2, single decorative together, single plus separate, single race separate. So you can see how many total single decorative, single plus 1, single race 1, total number is 4. So we can have conditions like this and have an elaborated table. So if I just press OK now, it's only divided according to levels. And if you just remove this one, itemize every instant, you can see level 1, we have 4 windows, 4 doors, 4 doors, 4 doors, 4 doors. It doesn't show item wise. So if you want to show item wise, just click on this. It will show item wise. Ascending, descending, everyone knows. So we now it will show the title, count and totals. Title here, count, and total individual, but it will not show you a grand total. So if you want to get the grand total here, how many full grand total doors, just click on this grand total. Okay, it will show you the grand total of 16. So here it will show you individual totals and the level name. So I hope you are okay with this. Just try it and see. So I discuss importing these columns. Then I filtered out if it requires. Then I sorted according to a level. So if you have a big project like this, you can nicely show. Otherwise, if you have only single level, you can do it according to families. So family and type. Now it will show me according to families. How many single decoratives are there? How many single plus 30 is there? Singles are 30, 84 there. So this may be also useful when it comes to calculations. So you can get the cost easily. Just do it and see. Any questions, please tell me. Any questions here? So you have to get the fields, then you have to filter if you want, then sort it. Then how can I get the total cost here? Or the total height, total height, those kind of things also can be taken. So how can I get the total cost? So to do that, we have to go to the next tab called formatting. If you just select the cost field, and there's a tool called calculate totals. So you just ask the software to calculate the cost of total cost. Okay, it will show you the total cost and the grand total. So this is just playing with some buttons only. You need to know what are the buttons you have to play. Click calculate totals. And if you try to calculate the width, can be done. Total width, but if you try to calculate the levels, you cannot add the levels, so you cannot add family levels, family and types. So those are only numbers you can add, not the names and the other information. So it's obvious. You can get the calculate torque. And these alignments can be changed, center. So it's center now. So the cost field is center. So those are obvious things everyone can understand. So you can align it horizontally, vertically, left align, center align, like this. And now if you talk about the last step, what is this show title? So title is now not there. So those kind of things are obvious things. You can just play with those buttons and understand. Show headers, these headers. So important in here is how to sort the things and get the grand total, and how to get the each and every column total. And if you come here to this area, field formats, just click on that, and now you can round off the things. Now the cost is in two decimal places. If you want, you can have zero decimal place. Okay, now the cost will be shown without decimal places from this. If you want, you can have digit grouping. So if you have big numbers like millions, just have a digit grouping. And you need I cannot add the units. If I want to add dollars, you can add, but unfortunately I don't have rupees in this list. So if you want, you can get a dollar value, but the rupees is not available here, but we can do it. I'll show you how to get it in a different manner. For the time being, we can't add rupees here. So just click on this and try to get the total. Then I will show you how to add the conditional formats. Oh, if I talk about this next one, conditional formats, we can actually highlight some cells. Now, if the cost is equal to 10, if the cost is equal to 10, and we can have another condition if you want, I can have a color, say yellow. Now, what will happen, everywhere which appears 10, field highlighted by yellow color. So you can quickly highlight. It's like Microsoft Excel. So you may have used Microsoft Excel and have done these things. You can have a conditional comment. Now, with this equal to 3, this can be viewed. So you can see how it works. So if you want to clear the things, we own. It's not there. Cost, click on the cost and clear the things. It's not there. So it's not a difficult thing. Just select the parameter you want. Go to field formats. Sorry, conditional formats. And now I selected the cost. And you can give a condition. 0. Now it's 0. 0 is not there, so it's not taken as 0 here, not, no colors will be applied. So I hope you are okay with this. We will look at how to write a formula. So this cost is based on a calculation done by me. So the calculation I did early, and I went to the drawers and I just manually gave the value. So this value I just calculated separately and gave it. But this value will not change when I change this heights and widths. So when you change this to a 3, 8 feet, this is not automatically going to change. So this is not, there's no relationship between this one and this one. So I have to do manual calculation and enter this value. So that is not really good. So if you want to have a calculation, if you want to have a relationship between this width and the height and get this value, can be done in Revit. So I will show you how to do that. For the time being, I will remove this cost field from the table. The table is without the cost. So I can add the first parameter based on the width and the, say, height of the window, for example. So I'm going to calculate the cost based on the width and the height. And automatically, when you change this width and heights, cost will change automatically. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to write a formula now, my own formula. So this can be the same cost, but this cost parameter, this formula, and there is another cost here. There's nothing, no relationship between them. So if you want, you can have, say, cost value. If you have this one only, also no problem. See, if I have it like this, it's a formula, it's a under common discipline, it generates a number, and I can write the formula now. Width times height is equal to cost. So this is a simple formula I'm writing. It calculates the area or the width. So if you want, you can get the calculation from the area itself. So this will calculate the area of the door, and it will have, say, something like this. So if we just try to press OK, it won't work, because this is just a number. This is a square meter or square millimeters value. So you have to remove the square meters or square millimeters. So we can do what? We can divide by 1 this. So what I have done is, here is, I have written a formula, and this will generate square feet, because I am in the imperial units. Now I have divided this by 1 square foot. So the units will cancel out. Then I can say this is equal to 15 rupees. So what is the meaning of this? 1 square foot is equal to 5 rupees. Then if you have 10 square feet, it's 10 divided by 1 multiplied by 5. So here the meaning of this one is 1 square, sorry, I will write like this, multiplied by 5. So here what we are doing is, we are cancelling out the units here. This is generating 1 square foot, and cancel out this 1 square foot. This is the hat. I don't have square symbol in the keyboard, so I have to use the hat symbol. And units are cancelled out, and it will be multiplied by 5. So if you just do this way, it will come here. Okay. Now you can see how it works. So 3 times 7 is 21. 21 multiplied by 5 is 105. So this is without any units. So you have to write the formula accordingly, otherwise it will give an error. So if you just look at this formula, this is the way we have written. So width times height is square feet. Square feet cancelled by the square foot here, and multiplied by unit value. So if the 1 square feet is 10 rupees, you can just do this. Any questions, please tell me. Okay, this is simple mathematics. This is simple mathematics. So if you have any questions, tell me. Here, why I am having this one is to cancel out the square feet. Otherwise, it will give an error, because this should generate a number. Now this is 10. Now this is 210. 3 times 7 is 21. 21 multiplied by 10 is 210. So you can see, I am getting a cost value. This has a big decimal number. So we can change the fields, no problems with that, and customize the decimal numbers. And if you want, you can get the total now. Total for this. So this is the value. And if you want, you can have formatting for this. It should have. Two decimal places. So you can have fix here, and fix the decimal place to 2, and you can have digit grouping if you like. Now it will be two decimal places, and you can see the comma coming now as a digit. So this will actually have a relationship between this one and this one. So if you just come and try to change this to 3.1, immediately your model will change. Model will change, and your cost tree is also going to change. So this is really handy. So you are changing the model from here as well, and your total cost can be seen at once. Remember, when you do a change here, your original model will change. So that's why it gives you warnings. This will change to all elements of type single, decorative, 36. You can see how it changes. So I hope you understood how I wrote this formula. Without typing this one, we can write this way also. One SF. So one SF can be also typed, that is one square feet, without typing the hat sign and the others. Say if it is a cubic feet, you just type CF. Otherwise, you type hat sign 3. So this way we can write cubic feet or square feet, or else just one SF will also work. So all these things are working. Okay, nothing changed. Done. So I will do this for the walls also and show you a little bit the same concept. So I will generate a wall schedule. We will get the area, family and type, say cost. Walls, you don't find a tool called levels. And you have this mason here, we have created that parameter also. And if you want, you can get the volume of the wall, width of the wall, height of the walls. Likewise, height is not available. So these kind of information we can take. Now it will show the entire project wall properties. So it says basic wall, interior, likewise, area, volume, width, cost is not given. And if I sort it according to family types, this is the situation. So you have basic wall, how much, what is the volume of basic walls, exterior metal stuff. So this is the result. So if you want, you can calculate the full volume of brick on metal stuff, full volume of basic wall interior. So if you want, we can do that with the calculate properties. Okay. So it will show you the full volume, and it will not show you the cost because I haven't given a cost for the wall. But suppose if you can come here and give a value for this wall, cost value. Is it okay? Now if I give 10 here, everywhere this wall is 10, this is 10, this is 10, everywhere it's 10, which is not accurate. So it depends on the area or the volume. So here it doesn't depend. So every wall has same cost, which is wrong. So this method is not good. That's why we have to write a formula. We can write a formula based on the volume or based on the area of the wall and get the cost. So this is not a good way of doing this. So don't go and just give a value. You can give it to doors because those are individual entities. But walls, this wall and this wall is different. Size is different. So it's not a good way of giving that, not logical. So you have to remove this. So you cannot just put zero here. That's another problem. Just leave it. Cannot put zero even. If you put zero, what will happen? Zero will come there. So better you not do that. So leave it blank. Now, if I want to write a formula based on the area or the volume of the ball, we can do that. So I'll do it. So this cost parameter is actually useless. So I will write my own parameter called cost. Even though I have the same name here, there's no overlapping, no problem. You can get a number and it's based on the, say, area. So if you just press OK, it will not have it. There's an error because this is the number, this is the area. So you have to divide this by 1 square feet. Say, suppose 1 square feet is 10 rupees. Better you have the brackets also. Okay. Now what? It says it's using, because this is used in the walls. You can't use it. Say new. Okay. Now there's no. This is useless. I just remove it. Okay. So this is the output. You have a lot of decimal places. We can format it easily. Get the cost here. Field formats. Get the fixed one. 2 decimal. Digit. So you can see it will calculate the total cost based on the area. So this is multiplied by 10, multiplied by 10, multiplied by 10. And if you want, you can get the total value. Total value is this. So it will show you the total cost for this wall type, total cost for this wall. Are you okay up to this point? Now, if you want, you can do something like this also. Now, I have written a formula separately. This formula can be actually embedded into the model. So, if you want, you can write different formulas and say calculate the salaries and other things depending on the square feet and other parameters. Otherwise, what you can do is forget about this formula. Don't use this. I can use this original formula and write a calculation not here, inside the model. Now, this is, I will show you again. This cost parameter is actually zero. This is door, sorry, for the walls. So this is a calculated value. I wrote a formula. If you remove that, if I take this normal one, there's nothing. So because it's not given here, nothing given. So if you give 10 rupees, it's unfair. So it should depends on the parameters here. It should depend on the structural parameters and the other things. So if you really worried about that, we can actually do that. So for an example, if you try to calculate the door cost manually, this is a cumbersome thing. So we can just remove this one and we can have an internal formula based on these things. This will be automatically working. So you can write it at the QS table level, no? In the model area even. So I hope you understand what I'm saying. So you can write a cost formula here even. I can write a formula here. Or else I can do it in the QS table only. Then that will be only for QS tables, not for the model. So if you want to do it in a model level, in the family level, simply speaking in the family level, we can go to door families. Now I'm going to write a formula. Now this is how the door has been made. So we haven't discussed these things, nothing discussed in this area. So how the door has been made. But here we are not going to do that. We will look at a tool called here, family category and parameters. So when you click, sorry, not that one, the below one, family tab. When you click here, you can see how the model has been developed. All the parameters are shown. So whatever we can see, here is they are in the family level. So somebody has done it. So somebody has done it for you. So I can also see what he has done. So family category and parameters. So not that one, below one, family types. So these are there. And my cost parameter is also here. Sometimes this may be collapsed. So you can expand the things. Cost parameters. So if you want, you can write a formula. So if you write a formula, here itself I can write the formula. So I'll write the formula based on the height and the width. So you have to actually type these parameters. Say height times. And I can divide it by square feet. Divide by 1 SF, multiply it by say 10. So if you have written it correctly, now there is an error coming because I have written simple edge. You have to have case sensitive, it's case sensitive. So you have to write actual cases like capital H, capital W. Now it's working. Now you can see it's modified automatically. So you can write nice formulas inside the model. So 7 times 3 is 21. 21 multiplied by 10 is 210. So when you press OK now, OK, I have done editing for the DAW model. To come here and check my model now. This is automatically calculated. So if I might check my QS table, this is now automatically. So in the QS table, I didn't write any formula. There's no formula here. So you can write even in the QS table and get the same result. But this is done in the model level, drawing level, family level. Okay, so 210 is coming. So this is somewhat advanced concepts. So if you look at this, another door, something like this. There is no formula written. So it's not a, it's not, there is no formula here. So if you want to write for this door, you have to change its family parameters. So it's written in the family level. So just come here and select family types. And you can write the cost formula for this guy also. So if I just write it like height, thickness, with everything into play. Divide by this time 1 cubic feet multiplied by 2. So if you are written correctly, spellings are wrong, it will show you the value. So it will multiply height, width and thickness. Height is 7, width is 3, 7 times 3 is 21, 21 multiplied by 2 is it's inches, so it will calculate height, width and thickness. Height, width and thickness and multiplied by 10, it will give you this value 34. And if you look at the model now, this is available. And if you look at the QS table, see, so any questions about this? So these are somewhat good areas. So I will definitely upload the video for you, so you can go through them at home. So we can play with the parameters. If the parameters are not enough, if these are not enough, we can have our Mason parameter, whatever the parameter I can have, and write a formula and calculate the things we need. So we can write our own formulas, we can create our own parameters, no problem. Even parameters can be created from here. So there's a tool called add parameters. So you can add that Mason if you like here, no problem. Or else you can go edit and create a new parameter. So everything is there again like the previous case. So I hope you understood the connection. So you can write a formula in the QS table, or else write a formula in the family level and get calculate the cost and other. So I will not go through these things. These are simple things. How to add the column, how to edit rows. So these are margin tools, so borders and points. This is the formula I told. We discussed that one, adding the formulas. So these are simple things. So you can go through these set in here. Any questions up to this point? You may have a lot of questions because we are not there physically meeting. So so if you are okay with this, next topic is how to get the material takeoff. We will quickly do that also, and I will remind it next day also. So are you okay with the basic setup here? Now here we counted the quantities. We didn't worry about the material they have used. So if you want, you can get the material volumes. Now how many brick, how much brick we need, how much other materials we need. So all the things can be calibrated from the software. So the same procedures, I will show you how this works, material takeoffs. I want to get the materials of the walls. We'll just take it, and say for the time being, I will just get family types. And if you just go down here, you will find the material areas. So material area can be calculated, material cost, and material names, material volumes. So these kind of parameters I can get. So other parameters also available, normal width and other things. Instead of that, we have new parameters, material areas and other. So if you just get the normal area, that is different from material. Some there may be areas which are not having material even. So now normally this will be equal, but we can see. So now if you press OK this time, it will generate the material table. So basic wall, every wall is listed out here, and the area is given, area of the wall, material area is given. Some walls, the both are same. And material volume given, material cost is not calculated. So if you come here and you sort it out, according to material type, we can sort it. And I can get the grand total. Now it will show me how much air material is used, air filtration, brick, how many bricks, how much brick I need to purchase. So if you want, you can now get the total brick volume or material volume. Now it shows me this much of brick I should purchase to construct this building. So if you just come here, it will show you how much the gypsum boards I need. So this is really useful. It depends on the material. It shows me the tables, gypsum wall boards, how much I need to purchase, and metal stud layers, how much, plywood, how much, vapor retarders, zero. So this is the material take. Only difference is we get now material columns. And if you want, you can write the cost formula same as before, same theory as before, all are same. So I formatted according to material name.
What are these?
What are these? What are these? What are these? What are
these?
So we will recap this one next day also. Next day I'm going to finish the class. So next Saturday we will have the last session. So next Saturday I'm going to look at this 13th chapter, and I'll show you how to create the drawing sheets. So some of the areas we already discussed, how to create the drawing sheets and how to put the dimensions and how to put the QS table inside this one. So those things we will going to discuss next day. So this will be our last topic for the syllabus. So I have a limited time, so I may go fast a little bit because of the time barrier. So next day we are going to look at this kind of a thing, how to generate the sheets and how to write your names and other things in the title block. So any questions for today's lesson? I will save this for the next day. We may need it. So we have to import this QS table to the drawing sheets. So have a model in your computer ready for the next day. So if you are okay with this, I will stop for today. We will meet next day. So thank you for participating to this session.